Dashjanega, who has thumped that into the hands of Longon. Well, what a disappointment. Agar's fifth wicket, a triumphant night for the tall, slim man from Perth. What a performance from him. 5 for 22 he has now from 3 overs and 1 ball.
Yeah, it's been a wonderful performance that by Agar, who comes in and bowls his left on spin, but he's been very skillful. Comes round the wicket, tries to get the ball to turn, a delivery against Andile Phehlukwayo. This one is from Nglungi Ngidi, who's trying to clear the boundary. Doesn't drop many. David Warner, comfortable catch, easy catch.
Well, I saw his first test match at Trent Bridge in England and thought, wow, what a cricketer in the making. Never quite evolved into the bowler that perhaps people thought he might be in the longer form of the game, though that may still come. And he can bat, bowl, field, and he's done for Ngidi. Look at this, the round the bat. It's another hat-trick ball. His second of the night. Wicket with the last ball of the previous over. Wicket with the first ball of this over. His fourth. A slip and a gully are in place. It couldn't be, could it? Oh! Only by a whisker has Ashton Agar failed to get a double hat-trick tonight. Or two hat-tricks, I suppose I should say. Double hat-tricks. 6 wickets and 6 balls. Ray Shamsi is, we might have had a run out. There's a fumble from Kane Richardson.
It was a tight one as well, wasn't it? The delivery was a good one. It was just a touch too short. Just misses the off stump. That's the run out chance. Possible. And he got the ball in his hand, Richardson.
Two balls left for Agar to finish with 6 for. Well, I figured against Rabada there was always a chance, as Rabada was certain to take him on. Tabrez Shamsi to face Ashton Agar's last ball of the night.